I'm not sure why New York used to look like this. When I was a teenager in the 20th century, the abortion debate was a bit more nuanced than it is today in the United States. Back then, Albany High School class of 1992, there was at least the notion of pro-choice and pro-life. Today, you're either pro-abortion in the US or no abortion. Unhealthy extremes in both cases as far as public health and women's health are concerned. But to French native speakers, the term avortement is a very violent term. Here's what we've done about it. On first reference, as often as possible, it's referred to as IVG, interruption volontaire de grossesse. IVG, as often as possible, is how it's referred to chez nous, les bleus. IVG, interruption volontaire de grossesse. Voilà la traduction officielle, me disent. Voluntary interruption of pregnancy. VIP. Voluntary interruption of pregnancy. Instead of saying abortion, voluntary interruption of pregnancy. VIP. Interruption volontaire de grossesse. IVG. La traduction officielle. Je suis bilingue anglais.fr. Vive le Rome Bologna. The other thing I think folks need to understand, le seuil légal pour effectuer un IVG chez nous, les pays membres du traité de Maastricht, l'Union européenne, beaucoup plus raccourci que chez eux, zone de l'art états-unisienne, échec, Doha, FIFA 2022. Voilà la preuve. Le seuil légal pour effectuer un IVG chez nous, Union européenne. Interdiction totale. Malte, Pologne. 90 jours. Italie, Autriche. 10 semaines. Portugal, Croatie, Slovénie. 12 semaines. Allemagne, Belgique, Danemark, Estonie, Lituanie, Lettonie, Hongrie, Roumanie, Finlande, Bulgarie, Grèce, Chypre, Luxembourg, Irlande, Slovaquie, Tchéquie, Espagne, 14 semaines, France, 18 semaines, Suède, 24 semaines, sur certaines conditions, Pays-Bas.